A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th May, on the front page you have Justice Bobde panel gives CJI a clean chit. So this is regarding the in-house committee headed by Justice S.A. Bobde, including even two women judges of the Supreme Court. So this committee's in-house committee has given CJI a clean chit in the sexual harassment allegations leveled by former Supreme Court staff member against the CJI. So the complainant says that my worst fears have come true. So the in-house committee said there was no substance in the allegations which were contained in the complaint of the former employee. Then this is fifth phase ends amid violence. So voting in the fifth phase was held in 51 constituencies across 7 states. But then in West Bengal it was seen the Trinamool and BJP workers clashes were seen. So several incidents of violence were seen in West Bengal and Jammu and Kashmir. Then on page 5 you have Pullavaram deadline pushed back. So this is regarding the Pullavaram project, which has been given the designation of a national project as such too. It's an irrigation project work in Andhra Pradesh. So the deadline for completing it has been pushed, and now the project will be completed by May 2020, according to Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh N. Chandrababu Naidu. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Posers on the Code. So this is regarding Model Code of Conduct. So the editorial says, in clearing PM Modi's speeches, the Election Commission risks its reputation for even-handedness. And second editorial, Deserved Penalty. So this is regarding SEBI's order on National Stock Exchange in the co-location case. So it says it's a welcome regulatory action. The lead article, A Miscarriage of Justice. So this is regarding the question whether the Honorable Justices will stand up as a collective conscience of the Supreme Court. So this is in the context of the in-house committee, which has declared that there is no substance in the complaint of sexual harassment against the CJI. And the second article here is Conservation Minus the People. So this talks about how, you know, India is moving away from community-involved conservation models, unlike rest of the world. So this is in the context of the forest management guidelines as such. The Forest Rights Act is proposed to be amended too. So here it is talking of, as we have seen, regarding giving powers to the forest officials to even shoot to anybody, indulging in criminal offense as such, violating forest laws. So that will be the power given to them. So rather than involving the community in conservation of forests, this is a colonial era mindset which has been used for forest conservation. Then on the op-ed page you have the Election Commission must act tough. So this article says by a former Chief Election Commissioner S.Y. Qureshi that it is sad that the debate now is about the Election Commission rather than the appalling conduct of our leaders. This is in the context of clean chit be given to Mr. Amit Shah and Mr. Modi by the Election Commission. Then this is regarding the S-400 missile too. So it says why Turkey is reluctant to abandon this Russian S-400 missile deal, which even India has gone ahead with. S-400 defense system. It's not just a missile, it's a defense system for which even Turkey is buying it from Russia, as well as India is undergoing negotiations, and US opposes both. On international page you have 1 million species at risk of extinction, United Nations. So the report says that industrial farming, fishing are factors that threaten to end existence of many species. So this is the entire detail given about extinction of species and how, you know, pollution is affecting, climate is changing, and how consumption is putting a strain on the resources. So this is 1800 page global assessment report compiled by United Nations. Then on business page you have RBI raises cap on home loans by SFBs, RRBs. So RBI has raised the cap, that is the eligibility cap on home loans by small finance banks and regional rural banks. So such loans will get a priority sector tag also. So here you can see, so the eligibility cap has been raised to 35 lakh rupees in metropolitan areas and 25 lakh in other centers, provided the overall cost of the dwelling unit and you know does not exceed 45 lakh and 30 lakh respectively. And all such loans will be classified as priority sector loans. Then this is DISCOM debt to return to pre-Udaya levels. So the aggregate external debt of state-owned electricity distribution companies, DISCOM is distribution companies. So this is set to increase to pre-Ujjwal, that is DISCOM Assurance Yojana, Ujjwal DISCOM Assurance Yojana, Udaya scheme. So pre-Udaya levels of 2.6 lakh crore is what has been seen, that the DISCOM debt would return to or would increase to that level. So, state-owned power generation firms have to become commercially viable now. So, this is a CRISIL report. So, it's analysis of DISCOMs in 15 states. These DISCOMs actually account for 85% of the aggregate losses. And on the last page you have, scientists carry out genetic study on people of Lakshadweep Islands. So, Lakshadweep, which is an archipelago of 36 islands, scattered over approximately 78,000 square kilometers of Arabian Sea. So this island is around 200 to 40 kilometers off the southwestern coast of India. So it has a population of around 65,000. So the genetic composition of the first human settlement of this archipelago is still not clear, but genetic studies have been done on the people here by a team of searchers led by IRF, CSIR Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology. So it shows that majority of human ancestry in Lakshadweep is largely derived from South Asia with minor influences from East and West Eurasia. So these are the important headlines. Due to elections, there is not much coverage in current affairs these days, which is good because you can concentrate on the annual current affairs revision as such too. And we also have started an initiative on our website asha.com. So this topic wise keywords as such gives you keywords for current affairs. So the entire, all the topics in current affairs have been listed down here and we are gradually filling it up. So culture has already been uploaded, culture and history, and even in geography uploading, we have uploaded the keywords. And even then for SNT, we have uploaded for Nobel. You can download the PDF here. So that is there, even a video has been made on it. Even for space, SNT space, for ISRO, the PDF has been uploaded, and gradually further PDFs would also be uploaded. So you can check them out. So that is it. Thank you.